Digital health and technology will help us provide better healthcare solutions for people with complex healthcare problems. The largest proportion of people coming into hospitals are older than 65. Many of them have multiple health problems. At this point in time, it's not feasible to do an individual study for each problem that we're trying to solve. So this is where digital health and large data come in. And what we're doing is to harness the power of routinely collected large data to try and dynamically monitor what the outcomes of the improvements are that we make. What we might do is use sensor-based technology to monitor their activity. Once we know how they move around, any change in the pattern of how they move might give us an indication of whether they're being well or whether they're experiencing a health decline. So our aim is to try and keep people as healthy as possible in their own environment.
Really only about one in five seriously injured patients have actually returned to how they were prior to the injury. It was around 2007 that we started following up patients and getting their perspective on how well they'd recovered. And that information is just absolute gold. In reality, it's the power that comes from the information from a lot of people that really drives the improvements in care for patients. We provide such amazing pre-hospital care and in-hospital care that at least 90% of our seriously injured patients will survive. And of course, 90% surviving means that we really need to be focused on the quality of that survival, not simply whether they've survived or not.